Well, after a drama-filled day for the Fairfax media empire, we pose this question. How will you read your newspaper tomorrow morning? It's something that we've taken for granted for generations, but financial reality is forcing fundamental changes in the way newspapers around the world operate and how you will receive their services. In truth, Fairfax is just the latest victim, today announcing major changes to mastheads that date back more than a century and a half. Eddie Meyer picks up the story.
We are making the biggest changes to the business ever made, and none of us underestimates the enormity of them. 1,900 people will be leaving the business over the next 3 years.
Despite growing fears in recent years, this was a headline Fairfax staff didn't see coming.
It's an emotional time. It's a difficult time. There have been tears on the newsroom floor.
1,900 people losing their jobs. What for? Not because of anything they did wrong, but because their board got the strategic decisions wrong.
Delayed maybe, but this overhaul is sweeping, directed at saving $235 million over the next 3 years.
We've never seen redundancies of this magnitude. This could be one in four, one in five of the remaining reporters going.
Fairfax printing presses will fall silent at Sydney's Chullora and Tullamarine in Melbourne. The company will also begin charging for its popular online content. The most profound change, though, the death of the broadsheet. Both The Age and Sydney Morning Herald will be downsized. Former Age editor Michael Gawenda says it should have happened years ago.
Digital revolution was always going to happen, but it would have given the papers a new lease of life.
Sectors that were profitable previously are going to struggle as the internet cannibalises different parts of the economy.
A brutal reality for a once proud news organisation, now the latest victim of the digital age.
Well, Harold Mitchell is one of Australia's leading media buyers. He's executive chairman of Aegis Media. He's also a columnist for Fairfax. He joins us from Melbourne. Thanks for your time tonight. Fundamentally, what's wrong with the Fairfax business model? Why is it not a good prospect for advertisers?
Well, Hamish, I think it's simply catching up with time. There's nothing wrong with what Greg Hybert has just announced today. The digital age arrived in 2000. It was the biggest change that's probably happened in the history in every way since the beginning of the printing press. Sounds a little bit grand. That's what's happened in the space of just 12 years. Advertising has moved to the digital world. It's now nearly 20%. Now, it took television twice as long to get to that level. That's the real change that's taken place. And I wouldn't despair too much of the changes that are underway now at Fairfax.
Well, aside,
it's true.
Aside from the 1,900 people that are going to lose their jobs, of course.
Well, let me put that into some context. If they stayed there, if it was an unprofitable company, if it was taken over, if it simply collapsed, there'd be no jobs for anybody. That's the reality of what business is all about. So there's nothing wrong with any of that.
Do you think that people that have been told today they could lose their job will be able to swallow that kind of sentiment?
That's pretty tough, I'd have to say that, but that's what business is about, you know. Now, it's possible that over time it should have happened more gradually, but it's much better, I should say, that Fairfax has decided at this time to do that, to protect the jobs that are still there and the business that's still there over a long period of time. This is a 150-year-old business. It's been through many changes. In the time that I've been in advertising, a fair time, I'd have to say, it's had some big changes of ownership, of what it is and where and how. The digital world is here. It's just as simple as that.
So whose fault is it then? Whose fault is it that they haven't caught up? It's been under the stewardship of Roger Corbett. Is it his fault?
Well, it's hardly for me to pick out individual people, I'd have to say, because
I'm sure you must have an opinion. You're one of the best brains in the business. Whose fault is this?
Oh, it's very nice of you to say that. I wouldn't say it's fault. Over a long period of time, all the major media companies worldwide have been underway with changes like this. It wasn't a matter of fault. In a very short space of time, 12 years is not too long to work out the changes that have taken place. Many other big media companies over a long period of time have had to change slowly or just disappear. All of that has happened. It isn't an individual. It isn't a board.
Okay.
And fortunately, at some point, they've just said, we've got to change it now. Just as well they've done that. I would defend them, the fact that they've caught up with reality. Someone's been prepared to do it, a board, and a chief executive said, we're going to do it now. I'm sorry about the people and the jobs. Understand that completely.
But that board that you've just talked about is likely to change significantly with this increased stake from Gina Rinehart. Is this, if you like, the end of sort of media plurality, rather, in the print presses in Australia?
Oh, I wouldn't say that. Do you know what's happening? Right now, our company controls 20% of all the advertising, and we have probably got 3,000 different places where we could advertise. It's changed just so dramatically. It isn't plurality in any way at all. There are just different ways everywhere that are emerging. The internet has changed it completely. As for a matter of the board, all boards change everywhere. They don't keep up to date with it. Gina Reinhart has taken a position. She's done something very interesting. Nothing wrong with that. She's put her money where her mouth is. She's after the rivers of gold. Now, perhaps from an old mining family, she was attracted to the fact that there was gold in them, their hills, and something can change. Nothing wrong with any of that. I shouldn't worry about this, other than the jobs. We're very sorry about that. Everyone would be. But better to lose the jobs that are there than the whole company and everybody's right. job.
You weren't sorry about them at the start of the interview. Nice to hear you sorry about them at the end. Harold Mitchell, thanks very much for your time tonight.
Thanks.